Hey, this one should be fun. We've got guests in from Southern California. So Thaddeus in West Hollywood, how are you?
Hi, I'm great, thanks. How's it going?
Pretty good.
The reason I called today is because I had a thought. I'm sure that everyone listening is well aware of Christianity's influence over American politics, and I'm sure more than a few people think that it's overly large.
Let me jump in for half a second here, Thaddeus, because I mentioned earlier that I was supposed to be on a Christian radio show on Friday, and so I was listening to the live stream waiting for them to call me. And this is a Christian radio show, and the host, because he couldn't take callers, decided to sing a song about the 12 days of Obamacare. So the political views have, I mean, it's not like anybody's even trying to hide anything anymore.
Right. But I was thinking about it because I was thinking that really a major tentpole of conservatism is personal responsibility, right?
Supposedly.
And I would say the foundation of Christianity is the exact opposite of that.
Yeah.
So I think the more people that realize this, I mean, original sin, we're all responsible for somebody else's mistakes. Like, that's the foundation of Christianity. I think the more people realize this, the more that they'll see how cynically they're being used and how any politician who claims to be a Christian is just logically can't be, or is so deluded to the point that it's just the sort of mental gymnastics are not the sort of thing that we would want to see in somebody who runs the country.
I think that could be effective for some, because Christianity is a label that applies to a vast array of beliefs and positions. But when you're talking about fundamentalists, they're tied quite often to political parties that work in opposition to their real welfare because of other positions. So, for example, I have relatives who are no doubt single-issue voters. It doesn't matter how bad or how good a party is on any number of issues and how it might affect their well-being. What their position is on abortion is the only thing that matters. And you know, they're doing it and explaining to them that the Bible doesn't actually have a position on abortion doesn't change it one bit. I mean, this is so ingrained in them that there's nothing that's going to fix this apart from a long period of time of getting them to give up those religious beliefs and embrace things a little differently.
You definitely have a point, and I know that there are people out there that vote like that. I was just hoping that the more people that look at it from this perspective can really see, cause I think to a point they know that they're being used, but I'm hoping that it gets to a point where they're being used so cynically that they eventually just abandon the political process altogether.
I can hope so. But I can't tell you what's going to happen in the future. All I can tell you is, you know, we can keep working towards a secular, rational society and hope we get there.
Yep. Well, keep up the great work, guys. I love your show.
Thanks so much.
Take care.
Bye-bye.